my most recent video presentation, I discuss new scientific discoveries that completely rewrite astronomers' ideas about planet and star formation. Technological data is now routinely suggesting that both planet and star formation appear to happen on a timescale that is not reconcilable with the slow, gradual processes in gravitational theory. Of course, this only supports a foundational tenet of the electric universe, which has always proposed that in a universe where electromagnetism governs the formation of celestial objects, every concept of cosmological timescales must be completely rethought. Today, the surprises in stellar science continue. Indeed, the discovery I'll be discussing today challenges the bedrock of astronomers' ideas about the formation of stars. Please note that this will be part one of a two-part presentation. The subsequent episode will address new discoveries by the James Webb Space Telescope of galaxies in the so-called early universe which, quote, go beyond what is possible, which is to say, they are beyond any explanation for mainstream cosmologists. Recently, a team of scientists working with the Sloan Digital Sky Survey discovered a star whose chemical composition is completely inexplicable, falsifying multiple bedrock theoretical assumptions about the origins and end of a star's life, assumptions about the early Big Bang universe, and assumptions about the formation of hypothetical black holes. The January 15th Science Alert headline, "Ancient Gigantic Star Exploded in a Way We Didn't Think Was Possible," summarizes the discovery as follows. A strange star in the Milky Way bears the signature of a unique explosion of a giant star that once existed billions of years ago, in the era of the cosmic dawn. The chemical composition of the extant star, known as J0931-0038, is so weird that it can only be made up of the leftovers of a huge star, one at least 50 times the mass of the Sun, that created the elements before it went supernova. And this is even weirder. A star that massive should, according to theory, have collapsed directly into a black hole when it died. Do not pass supernova. Do not collect weird element abundances. The star in question is a low-mass red giant star, whose full light spectrum scientists observed for the first time in 2019, in a region called the Milky Way halo. As noted in the above article, this chemical composition is, quote, unlike anything ever seen before. It was astonishingly low in elements with odd numbers on the periodic table, like sodium and aluminum, but rich in elements close to iron, like nickel and zinc. And then the abundances of elements heavier than iron, such as strontium and palladium, were much higher than they should have been. Now, in a paper accepted into the Astrophysical Journal Letters, the scientists proposed that the impossible star must have formed from the leftover material of a primordial star, 50 to 80 times the mass of the Sun. But again, here is the contradiction in their reasoning. In standard cosmology, any star that size is expected to gravitationally collapse inward rather than explode outward, as the scientists speculate. The co-leader of the research, astronomer Sanjana Curtis, acknowledges the quandary as follows. Amazingly, no existing model of element formation can explain what we see. It's not just, oh, you can tweak something here and there and it'll work out. The whole pattern of elements almost seems self-contradictory. Now, this discovery brings into focus a number of foundational theories in astrophysics today, including solar physics, gravity-centric cosmology, and Big Bang cosmology that the electric universe has always challenged. Number one, that stars are powered by nuclear fusion at their cores, and they gravitationally collapse when they run out of nuclear fuel. Number two, that stars form from the material left over from other stars that exploded as supernovas. Number three, that the earliest stars formed from the chemical components immediately available after the hypothetical Big Bang, which is currently estimated to have occurred about 13.8 billion years ago, although a recent scientific paper actually proposed doubling the speculative age of the universe to over 26 billion years old in light of the massively problematic data from the James Webb Space Telescope. Number four, that massive stars are expected to gravitationally collapse into black holes. Hypothetical neutron stars are also speculative, massively dense objects that supposedly form when stars gravitationally collapse. And finally, all of cosmology continues to operate under the incredible assumption that the Big Bang actually happened. First, on point number one, this provides a quick opportunity to explain why I and others in the Electric Universe community recognize the need to distinguish between plasma cosmology and the Electric Universe. Probably the most significant theoretical disagreement between the adjacent theories is that plasma cosmology subscribes to the notion that stars are powered by nuclear fusion at their cores, although plasma cosmologists do propose that electromagnetic processes are involved in forming stars and galaxies. This is also a chance to correct what might be the worst pseudo-criticism against the Electric Universe I've ever encountered, and that is the claim that the EU denies the existence of solar neutrinos. This, of course, is absolutely false. While the EU does not view stars as, quote, nuclear campfires in the sky, as Wal Thornhill used to colorfully describe them, it is always recognized that nuclear reactions absolutely happen on the sun. But in the Electric Universe, these phenomena occur on the, quote, surface of the sun. As Wal Thornhill wrote decades ago, the electric sun model expects far more complex heavy element synthesis to take place in the natural particle accelerators and the photospheric lightning discharges. In that case, all of the various neutrino flavors are generated on the sun. What actually happens in the core of any star is not settled science at all. Indeed, the first ever episode of Space News addressed the problem of the sun's apparent missing convection. The internal activity that helioseismologists inferred suggested only about 1 or 2% of the convection that the standard model requires. It is also not correct that the problem of missing neutrinos has actually been resolved. Decades ago, scientists on Earth discovered that they could only detect about 1/3 of the neutrinos predicted by the standard model. Science headlines pronounced in the early 2000s that the mystery was settled. That the, quote, missing neutrinos change flavor on their journey from the center of the sun to the Earth. However, as Wal Thornhill explained in our 2014 video, solar neutrinos in the Electric Universe, there can be no confirmation of neutrino oscillation between the sun and the Earth without simultaneous neutrino measurements being made near the sun. And of course, that poses formidable experimental problems. As we've pointed out many times, almost every visible feature on the sun challenges the belief that the sun is internally powered. For any newcomer seeking background on the Electric Universe model of the sun as an externally powered electrical discharge phenomenon, I recommend the fairly recent three-part Thunderbolts series by Dr. Donald Scott, culminating with the episode entitled, Indeed, Our Sun is Electric. Watch that series of videos, then see if the endless string of surprising discoveries we're discussing here begin to make more sense. Let me reiterate how important it is not to interpret this discovery of yet another, quote, impossible star as if it's an isolated anomaly. It's the opposite of an anomaly. It's a pattern demanding not ad hoc tweaks of popular theory, but rather entirely new theoretical pathways. Again, revisiting my earliest Space News presentations, I'm reminded of the discovery in 2012 of the so-called oldest star ever observed at that time, which was called the closest ever seen to the Big Bang universe. That star was composed almost entirely of hydrogen and helium, thus astronomers' inference of the star's primordial origins. But in standard reasoning, such a low-mass star requires the presence of heavier elements in order to form. As the lead author of a Nature paper on the discovery said, a widely accepted theory predicts that stars like this, with low mass and extremely low quantities of metals, shouldn't exist, because the clouds of material from which they formed could never have condensed. Just a few weeks ago, I discussed in a Thunderbolts video the observations of multiple other, quote, impossible stars, including the smallest ever observed so-called brown dwarf star, whose formation was described as gravitationally impossible. I also discussed new evidence of impossibly early planet formation about the disk of a star. And I can't count the number of times I've discussed the filamentary networks seen in star-forming regions in nebular clouds, filaments whose constant width is only explicable by the presence of electric currents. In the Electric Universe, stars form from whatever material is available in a molecular cloud at the time, and it is not possible to tell the age of a star in the Electric Universe. And of course, the Electric Universe did not begin with a Big Bang. On the question of the end of a star's life, I encourage viewers to review the March 6, 2020 interview I did of Wal Thornhill. entitled Supernovas, Neutron Stars, and Black Holes Break the Rules. We began that interview with a discussion of the so-called zombie star, a star that was observed to explode multiple times over a period of half a century. The description of that impossible star from a phys.org report is painfully familiar. The finding, published by Nature, completely confounds existing knowledge of a star's end of life. Somehow, this star exploded more than half a century ago, survived, and exploded again in 2014. In that interview, I think that Wall offered the most comprehensive explanation we've ever recorded on the life and death of a star in the electric universe. This includes preferable alternatives to the story of a star gravitationally collapsing into massively dense objects. Neutron stars were an incredible hypothetical conjecture whose very existence has been repeatedly challenged, if not refuted, by science discovery. We've discussed many times observations of so-called neutron stars that literally break the laws of physics. This includes neutron stars that shatter the Eddington limit, as well as a neutron star whose pulsar signal is apparently so rapid, it would require the object to mechanically spin like a lighthouse at about one quarter the speed of light, or over 70,000 kilometers per second. In contrast, the peer-reviewed paper co-authored by Dr. Anthony Peratt explains pulsars as essentially an electrical oscillation whose ideal analog is found on Earth in the device called the ion trap. Unfortunately, this experimentally verified, peer-reviewed plasma physics explanation receives no attention in the world of astrophysics. All of this goes to say that the entire story of the origins, life, and death of a star is a story whose foundational tenets have been systematically undermined and dismantled by science discovery. And you can't separate this story from the larger story of the Big Bang origins of the universe. Let me repeat the remark by astronomer Sanjana Curtis on the impossible chemical composition of the Milky Way star, J0931-0038. Amazingly, no existing model of element formation can explain what we see. It's not just, oh, you can tweak something here and there and it'll work out. The whole pattern of elements almost seems self-contradictory. Indeed, as you'll see in my next presentation, cosmologists' habit of tweaking popular theories, even in the light of self-contradiction, has led inexorably to the long-recognized crisis in cosmology. What does a crisis call for, other than a willingness to explore radical new perspectives? Perspectives such as those offered by the electric universe and plasma cosmology.